Worship. And it's Jesus who said in John chapter 4, and I know you haven't listened to how many of you, but it's important for today, that the hour is coming and is now here, when true worshipers will worship in spirit and truth. Indeed, the Father seeks such worshipers. So, in spirit and truth, in the gift of the Spirit, that we were given in baptism, we remember his side was pierced, water poured out, symbolizing that we would get the gift of the Spirit from him in our baptism. We worship in spirit and truth. And who we worship is God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. And in the Eucharist, so before we get there, the word worship, as I've done a few times in John chapter 4, is proskuneo, and it means to kiss. There's two Greek words, it's two retorts, and to kiss. So, it's an act of affection, an act of love, an act of devotion, to sing his praises. And there are times it's quite common for us to kiss our Bible, to the Eucharist touches our lips, a divine kiss. Some people really love to have an artistic depiction of Jesus, and they just kiss him. One artistic depiction of Jesus, it's just a black and a white. But the way that the paper's made, I'm not, this is so cool. Whatever the material of the paper is, that I've been kissing this thing, it's on a door upstairs in my room, and I walk by and I just give Jesus a kiss. And over the last 4.5 years, the oil of my face or whatever has started to make his face have the color. I can show it to you. It's no longer just black and white. The oil has allowed there to be a color. It's like, the more I love him, the more I'm experiencing his presence and going from black and white to like a developed image. It's really cool. I use it in my mind sometimes. I'm not kidding. It's awesome. And in the Eucharist, we worship God. And how do we believe that it's the real presence? That's what we speak about, that it's the real presence of Jesus. And I have just a couple more minutes of sharing with you, then we're going to do our last little faith sharing, but a slightly different version, as your notes tell you. We believe that it's his real presence, body and blood, because of his word. Because of his word. By the power of his word. In Luke chapter 22, Jesus, we read verses 19 and 20. Then he took the bread and said the blessing and broke it and gave it to them, saying, "This is my body, which will be given up for you. Do this in memory of me." His word is creative, his word is powerful. When he says it, it happens, and he turns bread into his body. And he says to them, "Do this in memory of me." And on his priesthood Sunday, it's okay day to say that. That's the heart of the priesthood, is that sacred power, not for the priests to speed and give out a speed ticket. I don't get a speed ticket. I've heard these stories of guys getting a speed ticket. Like, I get popped. My mom was like, "Patrick, just drive safe. It's not worth it." My mom asked me the other day, "How many points do you have?" Because I got a speeding ticket like a week ago. So, I was running late for a retreat. I was out the lady. And I had my collar on. I was like, "I'm going to lead the retreat." He's like, "Yeah, but you can't go that fast." And the officer was so apologetic. He's like, "Hey, I'm sorry about this. I got you for 5 over, not 15. I was in the middle of nowhere. So, look at me, defend myself. But he was apologizing. I was like, "Brother, I'm sorry. I'm the one who's driving too fast. You're right. I'm wrong." So that the sacred power of Christ is not for speed. So it's to do what he said, "Do this in memory of me. This is my body." And then Jesus in the last supper says, "This is the cup of the new covenant in my blood, which will be shed for you." He takes bread and wine, and by his blood, he follows through what lost him a lot of disciples in John chapter 6, the bread like discourse. A lot of people walked away because he didn't clarify it. He did clarify it. He spoke clearly that he was speaking literally about, "My flesh is true food, my blood is true drink." In John chapter 6, verse 66, that day many of his disciples no longer accompanied him. But he was telling the truth that his body and his blood would become food and drink for us. And it's a miracle where it looks like bread and it looks like wine, but it's really his body and his blood. And it's because of the power of his word. And then the gift of the Holy Spirit that we have helps us to know through the flame of faith in us that that's real. I believe him, and I trust his words in scripture and in conversation. He tells me, yes, I said this, and I said, do this in memory of me. I gave this power. So I believe it by the power of your word, Lord, it becomes your body and your blood. And now I can do what the Father seeks. I can worship proskuneo in spirit and truth. In the Holy Spirit I was given, I can worship you with joy. I can give you my love, my affection, your presence. And it doesn't have to be for any other reason except that you love me and I love you. And this is what lovers do. And so our last portion together is an act of loving adoration. And the gold vessel is called a monstrance, and it means to show. And we place a host in there, which has already been consecrated. And we gaze upon what looks like bread. And by the power of the Holy Spirit and believing in his word, we know that it's you, Jesus. And you can look at him with love. You can speak to him from your heart with love. It's a special sacred encounter that Jesus gives us in the Eucharist. And adoration is an extension of that. So we're going to do that for about 7 minutes. I'm going to put on some sweet little soaking music in the background and just tell them of your love. We'll have a special little blessing at the end. We'll welcome back the kids. And we'll conclude our generations of faith about the Eucharist, our first session, water, word, and worship. So just be comfortable. You can kneel if you want, but you can sit, you can be comfortable. The one thing you need is the thing the Spirit gives you, a faith to believe it's him, and to love him as he gazes at you with love. Us into the heart of Jesus, Holy Spirit. never about getting stuff from Jesus, but I just get this sense he wants you to ask him for something. That's okay. The way he operates, as you know so well, is you'll find something later. Oh my gosh, he did that too. He loves to love you. Now, if it's called the Christian benediction, you just lift up the host to make the sign of the cross. We believe it's Jesus giving his blessing on us. Baptism in the Holy Spirit. In the Word, he speaks to us and renews our mind. And in worship, we experience a loving embrace. And the most wonderful loving embrace is found in the gift of his body and blood in the Eucharist. Through his body and blood, the soul and divinity in his presence, we receive the grace and the blessings. Seconds and start loving children. Let's stand and sing a little song of praise as the Blessed Sacrament is placed back in the sacrament. Remember this one.
Bless the Lord, my soul.
This session to prepare a welcome to the kids back. Thank you, guys. So peace and love. Peace and love.